Hey guys, I'm Candy Washington and I am your personal coach on self-care. So today I wanted to really talk about ways to practice self-care that doesn't cost a thing. Self-care really isn't about, you know, taking trips or shopping sprees or face masks. It's really about the intentionality behind those actions. So you don't have to spend a lot of money. You actually don't have to spend any money to truly practice self-care. And to me, self-care just means taking time to honor the space that I take up, taking time to honor my own intuition and myself, taking time to recharge, and knowing that I am my first and best priority. So the first way to practice self-care that won't cost you a thing is to just mentally and emotionally check in with yourself throughout the day. And it's as simple as getting quiet and saying, how am I feeling right now? What am I feeling right now? And tap into those feelings. Maybe you have some underlying anxiety that you don't even know is there, but you just need to check in and get, you know, a hold on that. Maybe it's depression, or maybe it's, you know, worry or doubt. Maybe it's joy. Maybe it's happiness. Maybe it's nervousness. Maybe there's something, a gut feeling saying, don't do that. Or maybe it's a gut feeling say, hell yes, let's go do that. But you are so busy that you're not in tune with how you are feeling. So be sure to just slow down. Take a moment to yourself and check in with yourself. How am I feeling right now? Is there any tension? Is there any stress? How can I tell my mind and body to just relax and to slow down and to be in tune? And another great way to really get in tune with yourself is just to say, I am here now, and take a deep breath, focus on your breathing. I am here now. That brings you settled, that brings you into the present moment, and that lets you tap into what you are feeling right now. And that is just a very simple mindset shift. It doesn't cost you anything, but it centers you, it grounds you, and it gets you in tune and in alignment with where you're at right now. And then that will then inform the next right step for you. A second way to practice self-care that won't cost you anything at all is creating boundaries for yourself and harnessing the power of no. I struggled with this for a very long time. I had the disease to please. I always wanted people to know that I was always there for them. Anything they needed, I had their back. And, you know, I would just put their needs and their wants above my own needs and wants, whether it was convenient for me or not. I was the friend. I was the daughter. I was the girlfriend. I was a sister that would just always show up and just always be there. And I had to really learn how to say no. Because if I am continuously extending myself, but I'm not getting filled back up, then I am depleted. And I can't give if I have nothing to give. And I need to give with overflow. It's my cup runneth over. And what that overflow is for everybody else, but what's inside that cup, is that's for me. So I need to be mindful to keep my cup full. And to keep my cup full, sometimes I have to say, no, thank you for that invitation, but I can't go to that. Or no, I can't do that right now, but maybe down the line. Or no, but I still love you. No, not right now. No, not today. And no, I can't do that. And you don't always have to give an excuse or a reason why. If you don't feel like doing something, don't do it. And it's okay to say no. And don't feel that you're going to disappoint people. They're not going to love you. They're not going to like you. Because your value is not rooted in what you do for other people. Your value is rooted intrinsically. Because you are here, you are inherently valuable. You don't get value through what you do for other people. You get value for who you are. And it does no one a service. It does everyone a disservice if you are doing things that you truly do not want to be doing. And a good way to tap into the power of no is by using the power of intention. So think about, what is really the intention behind me doing this? Is my intention because I really want to do it? Or is my intention, I don't want to disappoint someone. I want everyone to think that I'm nice or kind. I don't want to appear to be selfish. You know, really tap into what is that true motivator? What is the real why behind your saying yes to something? And what's the real why behind why you want to say no to it? So you really want to tap into the intentionality of something. And based on that intention, you're able to create boundaries. And if people are unwilling to respect those boundaries that you set forth, then those aren't really your people. And then you have to really sit back and say, do I want to be friends with someone that is mad at me for saying no to them? Do I want to be in a relationship with someone that is angry because I create healthy boundaries in that relationship? You know, do I want to be at a job where my boss, you know, isn't flexible to what my needs and wants are in my role? So I think that creating these boundaries, harnessing the power of no, and really setting your intention it's not necessarily easy, but it is a free way to practice self-care. Creating boundaries, harnessing the power of no, tapping into your own intentionality. Those are all powerful self-care practices to make you become the best version of yourself and to really harness your own power and harness joy back into your life. You know, there's power when you say, no, I can't do that, but I still love you. And then you stick to that boundary and you hold yourself accountable and you hold other people in your life accountable too. There is power in that type of self-care. A third way to practice self-care, and this is one that I absolutely love and it's absolutely free, is to make sure that you are just moving your body every day and you are aware of what you are consuming in your energy and in your mind. So for me, that means going for a walk and popping in one of my favorite podcasts. There are so many uplifting, inspiring podcasts where you can really be mindful of the type of content that you're consuming. If you're always listening to, and I'm not saying don't be aware of what's going on in the world, but if you're always listening to, you know, news where it's just death, destruction, fear, division, that is the energy that you are feeding yourself. If you're always watching TV that it's around drama and negativity and fighting and commercialism and materialism, that is the energy that you're feeding yourself. So you have to be mindful of what you are consuming on an energetic level. You know, think about a food diet. If you put junk in, your body is going to respond to that. But if you put good things in your body, then your body will respond to that as well. Your mind, spirit, and soul, same. Energy, same. What you consume on an energetic level is what you will get out. So I love listening to podcasts. I listen to the Hey Girl podcast, Black Girl and Om, Oprah's Masterclass, of course, and Super Soul Sunday. But there are so many Girl Boss as well, Dear Sugars. But there are so many podcasts out there that can really tap into whatever it is that you are, you know, facing or going through or identify with that can give you healthy tools to cope with that. Or they're just happy and positive and open, you know, things to consume. So you really want to be mindful about what you're consuming on an energetic level. And that's completely free. You know, pop in a podcast, go for a walk. You know, maybe you don't want to go to the gym, walk around the block, you know, go for a hike, you know, lay on your couch if you don't feel like, you know, doing movement. Pop in the podcast and just listen to it. Just let your mind, you know, consume things that are feeding you and that are in service of your higher self. Now, I'm not saying to listen to the news. I'm not saying to watch, like, reality TV. Like, trust me, I do all of that. But there has to be a healthy harmony within the type of content that you are consuming. So I hope that you found this helpful. Just three free ways to practice self-care. The first one is to check in with yourself. How am I feeling right now? I am here now. The second, creating healthy boundaries, harnessing the power of no. No, I can't, but I still love you. And the third is being mindful of the type of content that you are consuming and do movement of body. Pop in a podcast, go for a walk, you know, meditate, clear out all the noise, and just get back centered. So I would love, 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 love for you to join me in the comments below and in the notes below. You can see links to join me for a little bit of self-care. If you want a coach to help you with this, or if you just, you know, really need someone to talk to you about what self-care is, what it means for you, and how it can transform your life, you can email me at info@candywashington.com, and you can find me at candywashington.com. And also there's a link below for where you can sign up for some coaching if that is what you want. So sending you guys all a lot of light and love.